Hunters coming up next with tonight's superstar album at Bruce Springsteen's Born to Run on KQB 106.
We're WKQB Nashville. Hunter here, and Bruce Springsteen's up next. Bye, Nick. That was a nice one. Weather out's going to be pretty good. Fair and cool this morning. Sunny and warm later today. High 75. Gosh, just like summer. Low tonight, 46. For the weekend, sunny with highs in around 70. Right now, 54 in Nashville. Let's get into it. Bruce Springsteen, a superstar album at KQB 106, Born to Run. Bruce Springsteen, Born to Run on KQB 106. It's our all-night album. Pardon me, superstar album. And we're going to get into the other side in just a second. Hunter here, and the bee was out yesterday running around. Stopped into a couple of places. First one in the morning was Red Cap Industries. They're out there on Massman Drive. Diane Vaughn was listening, and she got her package of goodies, and she got her KQB-FM radio, just for keeping us listening at work. The bee's going to be out and about later today doing that again, so if you're listening at work, you want to be sure and tune us in, because the bee's going to be listening for KQB 106. Rap House has got free counseling for people with problems of any kind, economic, personal, psychological, sexual, you name it, they want to talk to you. 292-3313, Rap House. 1701 Portland Avenue. Free counseling. Nice people. Beautiful morning. Fair and cool again, and another sunny day coming at us. Morning lows is going to be 42. Today's high is 75. Pretty warm. Right now, 54 in Nashville, and the weekend looks just about the same. Let's get into the other side now from Bruce Springsteen. It's our superstar album this morning, Born to Run on KQB 106. KQB 106, a superstar album from Bruce Springsteen, Born to Run. Just had ELO, Styx, and Moody Blues on KQB 106. Fair and cool for now, and then another sunny day coming at us. Morning low 46, today's high 75, and for the rest of the weekend, hooray, sunny skies, highs 70. Right now 54 in Nashville. Rolling Stones on KQB 106. We're going to be playing something from that new Fleetwood Mac as soon as he gets here. This is KQB 106. Hunter here. And telling you about what's happening down south of us in Hotlanta. Those people have got an unbeaten National Hockey League team. The Atlanta Flames rolled over the St. Louis Blues 5-2 last night to remain the NHL's only team without a single loss. Way to go, Atlanta. Looking good. And Monday morning is looking real good for us here for the all-night album replay. That is, if you're into Led Zepp. Because we're going to do more than a little bit of them. We're going to start out with Led Zeppelin, and then Led Zeppelin 2, 3, 4, and then Physical Graffiti. And after that, Houses of the Holy. So it's going to be a Led Zeppelin Monday morning at KQB 106. Sports Car Clubs of America say to take your big cars, especially out to the last autocross of the 78 season at the Opryland parking lot. It's going to be Sunday. Register at 10 in the morning, and first car off the line, running one at a time against the clock at noon. You can watch for free. Get out here and watch those cars race around. And might as well get back into ELO now at KQB 106. Gino Vanelli from Brother to Brother on KQB 106. Great morning and a nice day coming at us. Fair and cool for now. Sunny later. High 75, low tonight 46. And for the weekend, sunny with high 70. Right now 54 in Nashville. Beatles, KQB 106. Jethro Tull on KQB 106. Hunter here, and Nick's still around. Actually, he's been working out a little bit because some guys came up here by the name of Player. You might remember them from a little bit earlier. We sure have been playing from Player lately. In fact, they're going to be concerting in our area pretty soon, so we'll probably hear all about that. Nick's got a few words with Player. Let's hear it right now on KQB 106. That's it. KQB interviews Player, and gosh, you ought to get out there and see him in Clarksville. They're going to be playing with X. KQB 106. 10:50 tonight, we got a mini concert from the Eagles. Out there it's fair and cool for now. Another sunny day. Low this morning 6, today's high 75, and for the weekend sunny with high 70. KQB 106 Moody Blues. Wondering where to get a rear window sticker for KQB. It's pretty easy to do with the Pizza Huts. Just go into any of them and say, I want a rear window sticker for KQB 106. They'll hand it to you, and then you just wipe the grease off, slap it on the back of your window, and show off to the world. 6:50 tonight, we're going to have a mini concert from Joe Walsh. It'll be nice. Tennessee Energy Authority's got something they call thermogram displays. They made some overflies in aeroplanes, or possibly satellites, and they picked up some infrared photography to figure out where the heat's coming out. So if you want to actually see how your house is doing, go by Madison Library till the 11th of this month, and then after that at Nashville Gas and also NES. For more information on all this thermogram business, it's pretty important, might save you some bucks this winter, call them 741-6671. From Deja Vu, Crosby, Stills, Nash & Young at KQB 106. All aboard. All aboard. KQB 106. Steve Miller Band there from Fly Like an Eagle. Wow. Nightly at 6:20 and 10:20, we pass on information about concerts in the area, as well as every place you can find music in Nashville, and that's mentioned in quite a few. Nice morning. Fair and cool for now. Sunny later on. Sort of like yesterday. Hooray. Morning low 46. Today's high 75, and for the weekend, sunny with high 70. Right now, 54 in Nashville. Here's Styx on KQB 106.
Oh, mother.
KQB 106. Paul McCartney and Wings on KQB 106. The bee was out running around yesterday to see who was listening at work and stopped in at the Lochinvar Water Heater Company over there on Sidco Drive. And the people were, in fact, listening, so they got their special KQB-FM radio. And also Kay Bradley of the advertising department picked up her own T-shirt, and gosh, it looked good on her, plus her special package of KQB goodies. Later today, that old bee's going to be out again listening for KQB 106. Hope you're listening. Nice morning and a great day ahead of us. Fair and cool right now, then another sunny day. Morning low 46, high today 75, and for the weekend sunny with high 70. Right now 48 in Nashville. Crosby, Stills, and Nash at KQB 106. Foreigner on KQB 106. Hunter here. And want to mention that we've got some new albums on KQB 106, including Jean-Luc Ponty, Neil Young, and Toto. Just a few minutes, we're going to do some Stones and Neil Young. So listen in for that. Tennessee Department of Agriculture's got a plan for you that might involve some munchies. We'll tell you about that in a second.
Frank Davis, Mountain Road near Sears Shopping Center.
Having a food festival out at Ellington Agriculture Center Thursday and Friday, yesterday and tomorrow. The state ag people and have got together, and they're going to have a whole bunch of people out there. Demonstrations and exhibits and probably all sorts of snack trays. It's free parking and free admission, so go on out there if you need a free lunch. That's just a hint. I don't know for sure that they're serving, but it'd probably be worth it. Deep Purple now on KQB 106. Beatles on KQB 106 here with Hunter. A little earlier we did have some people up here that were actual stars and a former player. Maybe we'll hear from them a little later when we roll that tape again. Hope so. Otherwise, don't forget we've got that midday mini at 10 before lunch on KQB 106.
Gallatin Road near Sears Shopping Center.
Fair and cool for now, and then another sunny day. Morning low 46, today's high 75. It's kind of warm, almost like summer still. And the rest of the weekend's going to look great with sunny skies and high 70. Right now, 48 in Nashville, Rolling Stones, KQB 106. KQB 106. Ambrosia on KQB 106. Just ahead, Stones, Boston. And then we're going to be talking about that amateur hour Sunday night at 8 o'clock. A little bit later, you'll be hearing about that on KQB 106. Fair and cool for now, and then another sunny day. Hooray. Morning low 46, and today's high 75. For the weekend, sunny with highs 70. Right now, 48 in Nashville. Got Van Morrison, Moon Dance. Let's practice that step on KQB 106. KQB 106. That's Rick Derringer, All-American Boy. We're going to be moving right on through the morning with you. I'm Hunter, and Sunday Funnies are Sunday night, looking ahead a little. Starting off with the Amateur Hour at 8, and then the Comedy Hour from 9 to 10, and Dr. Demento from 10 to midnight, a classic. Check it out. You'll love it. On KQB 106.
Frank Davis, Gallatin Road near Sears Shopping Center.
There's something going on at Vandy Divinity School that's of interest to some of us, at least. Crisis Intervention's getting together with the Rape and Sexual Abuse Center, and they're going to hold a rape awareness workshop at the Div School. It's going to be Saturday from 8:45 in the morning until 5 in the evening. For more on it, call them at 322-2706. Al Stewart, KQB 106. We're WKQB Nashville. Neil Young from his latest Comes a Time on KQB 106.
In this world of pointless fear, filled with empty talk, how is it we are here? How is it we are here?
KQB 106, Moody Blues here, and if you're wondering where to get that bright red dot that you're seeing all around town, talking about the rear window sticker for KQB, well, several places out of town have got them now, too. And if you're in Cookville, you can get them at Maxwell's. Just ask them for a rear window sticker for KQB 106. Nice morning going on. Going to be another great day. Sunny and beautiful. Today's high 75. Tonight's low 44. And for the weekend, continuation of great weather. Hallelujah. Sunny with highs 70. Right now, 45 in Nashville. Here's Eagles on KQB 106. ELO on KQB 106. Coming up, Beatles. And what else? Well, some Stones. Chicago, too. And a little bit later, we're going to tell you something about where you might find some buys out there across from Richland Park Saturday. Morning's really nice. It's going to be another great day with lots of sunshine. Holding through the weekend. Today's high 75 and low tonight 44. Highs for the weekend about 70. Right now 45 in Nashville. Beatles from Sgt. Pepper's at KQB 106. Rolling Stones on KQB 106. Later on this morning at 8:50 to be precise or approximate or actual, Casey's going to tell us some news we can use. And she's going to tell us about ring around the collar, how to get rid of it by buying the right washing machine. That's news you can use with the great little Casey Maxwell, 8:50 this morning on KQB 106. Another great day. Sun's going to shine, see some blue sky, and probably a few clouds and nice gold-colored leaves. High today, 75. Tonight's low, 44. And the rest of the weekend's going to continue good with sunny skies and highs, 70. Right now, 45 in Nashville. Chicago on KQB 106. Crosby, Stills, and Nash on KQB 106. That KQB stopped by EBM Incorporated at 1625 Broadway yesterday, and the people over there were buzzing before we got there because they were listening while working, and they got their own special KQB-FM radio, which is what's happening quite a bit these days. Trish Moss and Terry Johnson, who sent in a letter initially, got their own special package of KQB goodies, and the T-shirts looked really nice on those ladies. Later today, that old bee's going to be out again listening to KQB 106.
Near Sears Shopping Center.
Nice morning going on. It's going to be another sunny day. High 75, low tonight 44. Weekend outlook sunny with highs 70. Right now 45 in Nashville. Got Steely Dan on KQB 106. KQB 106.
That's Al Stewart on KQB 106. Good morning. This is Casey Maxwell. Here's what's happening. Campaigning for a third term in the Senate, Republican Howard Baker called yesterday for a bipartisan battle against inflation. Baker's on a four-day whistle-stop tour across Tennessee, which is due to end today in Memphis. In Nashville yesterday, Baker said Republicans would help President Carter with his anti-inflation program if he includes as part of it a general tax reduction and a serious effort to trim federal spending. Baker is the highest-ranking Republican office holder in the nation as the minority leader of the Senate. Meanwhile, his opponent, Democrat Jane Eskin, said yesterday at news conferences in four cities that Baker failed to vote for ethics legislation that would have prevented conflict of interest among senators. Baker said Ms. Eskin failed to do her homework on the matter. The election's only 6 days a week. Tennessee Valley Authority may set aside part of its coal market for small producers. That was the message yesterday from TVA Board Chairman S. David Freeman in Knoxville. Freeman said the TVA is concerned about a growing threat of price manipulation by energy conglomerates. Freeman said it's important for TVA to help encourage competition in the coal industry. TVA's the nation's largest coal buyer. Freeman said he's receptive to the idea that TVA pay higher prices for coal from smaller producers than it could get from larger ones to foster competition. He asked Commissioner Richard Freeman to approve the first phase of the program next week so that the new policies could go into effect immediately. The policies include removing reclamation requirements for small firms and speeding payments to help the small firms with cash flow problems. U.S. Attorney Mike Cody says he may ask for a full-blown hearing before a federal appeals court on a case involving legislative immunity, a bribery charge, and Memphis Democrat Ed Gillick. The 6th U.S. Circuit Court of Appeals ruled yesterday in Cincinnati that Gillick's position as a state senator entitles him to some degree of privilege, but not as much as the lower court had granted. Cody said the Court of Appeals rarely holds a full hearing after making such a ruling, but he may ask them to do so in this case. Gillick was indicted in 1976 on charges of interfering with an extradition case and, in a separate case, of misusing his public office by attempting to push legislation to help four men obtain master electrician licenses, all in exchange for money. Gillick's attorneys have argued his actions as a member of the state legislature are not subject to review by the courts. Under that line of reasoning, defense lawyers have managed to suppress most of the evidence against Gillick. The State Board of Equalization has decided that property owned by railroads and public utilities should be reappraised as other property is assessed. The decision follows guidelines issued last spring by federal judge L. Clure Morton in Nashville. Equalization Board Secretary David Whitfield said the judge had effectively lowered the appraisal of railroad property from 100% of fair market value to 63%. The railroads had argued it was unfair to tax them for 100% of the market value of their property, while other property was appraised at a lower rate. Whitfield said the board's action yesterday affirmed that decision, granting relief to five railroads and about 125 public utilities in Tennessee. Two Soviet cosmonauts are heading back to Earth today after spending nearly 140 days in space aboard the Salyut 6 space station. Radio Moscow reports the men have boarded their spaceship for the return trip. The dollar rallied on the Tokyo Foreign Exchange today. It closed at just over 186 yen, more than 7 yen higher than yesterday's close. Sources say the Tanzanian government is preparing a major strike against Ugandan troops occupying the northern part of the country. The Ugandans are in control of about 700 square miles of Tanzanian territory, and they say they plan to keep it. The Arab League summit gets underway today in Baghdad. The heads of 21 Arab nations will be discussing a response to the Egyptian-Israeli peace initiatives. On the sports page, three former assistant football coaches at Vanderbilt, working now as assistants elsewhere, say they're interested in succeeding Fred Pankost at Vandy. Pankost announced earlier this week he would resign at the end of the season. The three are offensive coordinator John Cropp of Ole Miss, defensive coordinator George McIntyre of Ole Miss, and backfield coach Bob Cope of Arkansas. Both Cropp and McIntyre worked under Steve Sloan when he was coach at Vanderbilt in 1973 and 74. Sloan is now the coach at Mississippi. Athletic director Roy Kramer said he hasn't set up a schedule for selecting a new coach, but says he's getting plenty of advice. The Southwest YMCA is having an open house on snow skiing. They'll have equipment demonstrations and instructors on hand to answer questions. It's the Southwest Y in Green Hills, Sunday, 1 to 5 p.m. KQB weather, generally fair today. High of 76, low at night 44. Right now it's 45 in Nashville. This is Casey Maxwell.
Thank you, Casey. It's now 5:30 on your morning, and we've got the Who at KQB 106. Eddie Money, Ready Cash on KQB 106. We've got an amateur coming up here Sunday night at 8 o'clock. Marlene Litoff lives here in town and goes to school out there at one of the colleges. And she's 20 years old. She's going to be our amateur from 8 to 9 on the Sunday Funnies, KQB 106. Real nice morning going on. Going to be another great day, kind of sunny, few clouds here and there. Today's high 75, low tonight 44. For the weekend, it looks grand. Really decent. Sunny and highs 70. Right now 45 in Nashville. Fleetwood Mac, KQB 106. KQB 106.
Atlanta Rhythm Section on KQB 106. Good morning, this is Casey Maxwell. Here's what's happening. The state Supreme Court has begun deliberations on the constitutionality of the new state anti-obscenity law. But the five justices indicated yesterday they may not have enough facts to decide the matter. The court heard two challenges to the anti-obscenity law, one filed by two Memphis nightclubs and the other by a group of Nashville bookstore owners and librarians. Each group says the law is too vague. Justice William Harbison asked one of the lawyers challenging the law to give the court a specific example of what may be banned that shouldn't be banned. He received none. The author of the law, former Memphis prosecutor Larry Parrish, is defending it in court. He bore down on the challenger's failure to specify how they might be affected by the law and asking the challenge be dismissed. Nashville voters have until 4 today to cast absentee ballots in the November 7th general election in Davidson County. The ballots can be cast between 8 this morning and 4 this afternoon at the Election Commission headquarters in the Metro Office Building. Election Registrar Gynell Sanders said more than 1,400 persons have already voted absentee in person, and another 1,038 have requested absentee ballots by mail. The Middle Tennessee counties surrounding Nashville continue to grow at a faster rate than the state capital's own Davidson County. The fastest growing county in the area was Williamson. A population study released by the governor's office yesterday showed Davidson County grew by 1.4% from July 1976 to July 1977. At the same time, the neighbor counties grew by greater amounts. Williamson had a growth rate of 41.9%. Others were Dickson, 22.4%, Cheatham, 37.2%, and Robertson County, 14.4%. Other county totals were Sumner, 31.4%, Wilson, 25.9%, Rutherford County had 41.9%. A Nuclear Regulatory Commission staff report says the agency should reject a Tennessee woman's petition to shut down all nuclear facilities in the country. The commission received the report yesterday, and Chairman Joseph Hendry said the group would study the document before deciding what to do with it. Janine Honaker, the anti-nuclear activist from Nashville, filed the petition, saying that continued operation of nuclear facilities threatens the public health. The Army says it's trying to wrap up its investigation to determine whether any of its Cobra helicopter gunship pilots who made a low pass over Tennessee Commune should be disciplined. On October 24th, a file of olive green and camouflage helicopters on their way to a training camp in Florida dropped out of a low cloud bank near Summertown and the farm, a southern Tennessee commune. Residents of the 1,750-acre commune, some of them Vietnam War veterans, say the pilots maneuvered as if they were practicing an attack. It's less expensive to live in Chattanooga and Knoxville than in the average American town. That's what a survey by the American Chamber of Commerce Researchers Association shows. The survey says a rating of 100% is average. Both Knoxville and Chattanooga are lower than that. Knoxville has a 92.5% rating, and Chattanooga a 95.8% rating. The Voice of Vietnam says many Vietnamese soldiers were killed or wounded yesterday by Chinese troops, but precise casualty figures were not available. The radio broadcast says the Chinese, possibly numbering in the thousands, crossed the border into Vietnam yesterday, surrounded the Vietnamese soldiers, and opened fire before returning to China. The wholesale price index for October is due out this morning. Indications are that it'll be up sharply for the second month in a row. The September figure reflected a 0.9% increase in wholesale prices. This should be a good month for stargazers, with a pair of meteor showers brightening the skies. The first showers expected to last several weeks, centered on November 8th, with up to 10 meteors an hour streaking through the sky. Astronomers say the second shower, on November 17th, is more unpredictable, but meteors either appearing in greater numbers or not at all. On the sports page, the Philadelphia 76ers have won their fifth straight National Basketball Association contest, a 116-115 victory over the San Antonio Spurs. And the $200,000 National Team Golf Classic starts today in Lake Buena Vista, Florida. Vanderbilt quarterback Van Heflin and back Frank Mordica are among the leaders in the Southeastern Conference in passing and rushing. Heflin is fifth in passing and sixth in total offense. Mordica ranks fifth in rushing. Vanderbilt prepares this week for a game against Memphis State in Memphis. Memphis State, 2-5, rates a slight favorite over the Commodores, who are 1-6. Tennessee tight end Reggie Harbor worked out with the team yesterday, but his status remains uncertain for this week's football game against Duke. Harper's the Vols' leading receiver through six games. He injured his knee last week in a loss to Mississippi State. The South Street Community Center has daycare for kids 3, 4, and 5. Call 256-5108. KQB weather generally fair today. High of 76, low at night 44. Right now, 45 in Nashville. This is Casey Maxwell.
Thank you, Casey. Time is now 5:59. Hunter's getting ready to run away, but Ronnie's on the way, so stay with us through the morning at KQB 106. That's Dan Fogelberg, Tim Weisberg on KQB 106. Good morning. Hi, it's Ron at 6:10. Casey's here. Hunter's still here. That's the lowest kind of type of... I just love this time of morning because everybody just kind of hangs around, jaws with one another, you know what I mean, just kind of runs it down and says, hey, what's happening? What's happening, man? Okay, we'll be checking with Paul Randall Dickerson here in just a few minutes. Something I want to tell you about is happens 6:20 and 10:20 every night. It's KQB Soundcheck. We run down the area concerts, regional concerts, and who's playing what clubs around town. Let's find out where to go to party and... like I said, that's 6:20 and 10:20 in the evening. So, if you have it radio on after work today, KQB 106.
Michael Murphy, this Saturday night at the Exit Inn.
All right, it's 6:12 on the old horn with me is Paul Randall Dickerson. How you doing this morning, pal?
Doing well this morning.
Got a hot sports story to pass along to the listening audience this morning.
Yeah, I kind of do. Hockey is not the hugest sport in this area, but there's some people who follow hockey, and this is a pretty big thing.
Okay.
Bobby Hull.
Yep.
I remember about 15 years old, big news with Chicago and the NHL.
Exactly.
I've been playing WHL hockey for about 7 seasons now. At the age of 39, he's hanging up his skates, going to retire from professional hockey.
Oh, no.
And be singing the Mickey Mouse song down at Lake Buena Vista, Florida. Which is right outside of Orlando. $200,000 National Team Golf Classic starts today. Now, here, there's on the north side of town is Lake Buena Vista Road. But down there, it's Buena Vista, Florida. And the Atlanta Flames have extended the National Hockey League unbeaten streak to 11. They shut out Philly's Flyers 3-0, and the Flames remain the only unbeaten team in the NHL.
I see. Well, okay.
Now, this morning, which